Sepelire la sui montagna. Bella ciao, bella ciao, bella ciao, 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 e sepelire la sui montagna sotto l'ombra di un bel fiore.
Love him, hate him, Bolin is no doubt one of the most memorable characters from Money Heist. He's insanely charismatic but is also cruel and shows strong psychopathic tendencies. But it is this complexity about his character which has made him a fan favorite. The Popcorn Theory brings to you 5 memorable Bolin moments which will help you explore this complicated character. After Tokyo tries to lead a mutiny against Bolin, he feels that she has become too unstable and may risk the heist. So he straps her up and pushes her out of the mint in what is perhaps the most iconic scene of Money Heist.
You look like a birthday present.
I think this scene conveys just how big an egomaniac Bolin actually is, and that everything that he does has to be larger than life, even revenge.
No, I'm not gonna kill you. And I won't be torturing you either. Of a beautiful friendship.
Okay, so this one is a personal favorite. At the starting of the series, nearly everyone thought of Bolin as a self-centered, narcissistic, emotionless man. Almost a psychopath, definitely a sociopath. So everyone was surprised when he volunteered to represent the gang in a live interview at the Mint. During the interview, he appeared as this broken, dying man, defamed by the police, and thanks to him, the interview successfully generated enough public sympathy for the gang.
La policía miente. Miente a la opinión pública. Han mentido a mis amigos. Han pisoteado el nombre de mi familia. Soy un ladrón. Pero tengo todo el derecho del mundo a no ser difamado. Tengo el mismo derecho que cualquiera a morir en paz y con dignidad.
But do you think that this was merely an act for the press interview? I think that this moment may be one of those moments where we actually get to see just how vulnerable Bolin was. After all, he did seem genuinely hurt about the lies that the police had spread about him. Bolin's wedding in season 3 set for a sweet nostalgic delight for his fans. The highlight of the scene was Bolin's philosophy about love, life, and betrayal. After the professor rebukes Bolin for marrying a much younger woman despite knowing that he will die soon, calling it selfish betrayal, Bolin offers him an interesting perspective. Under the right circumstances, anyone can betray.
The betrayal doesn't depend on how much or how deeply you love someone. It depends on the magnitude of the dilemma they put in front of you.
Would you betray your loved one?
At first, no. But what would happen if someone told you that if you did, you'd be given a medicine that could cure your beloved brother, huh?
Let me explain my point now. Love and betrayal are significant themes in Money Heist. Raquel almost betrays the professor to save her mother and daughter during her interrogation. Similarly, Tokyo's mother had almost gotten her arrested, hoping that that would save her from being chased and killed by the police.
Mom, are you alone?
Yes.
Bolin stood corrected. Even a loved one can betray you if they are facing difficult circumstances. Money Heist has many beautiful and intense moments about love and togetherness, but the kiss that Berlin and Palermo share is special in so many ways. While Berlin identifies as a heterosexual male, his best friend Palermo is deeply in love with him. Berlin knows this, and a part of him wants nothing more than to be able to love his best friend back, but he simply cannot.
I have to leave you. It's because of love. And also for our friendship. For the bond I have with you. Adios, my friend. I'm confident that one way or another, time will bring us back together.
Berlin is a creature of love and passion, as he said in his own words, and watching him struggle with his relationship with Palermo was a beautiful and painful experience. For a world that is still trying to adjust to the idea of homosexuality, this scene was definitely an opportunity to take another step towards understanding. Unrequited love hurts, no matter from where it comes from and for whom.
Helsinki, blow the tunnel.
No.
Get down! Helsinki, that's an order, soldier. Blow the tunnel!
No, don't do it.
I will be honest, I wasn't the greatest Berlin fan until, ironically, his death. But seriously, he makes up for most of his egocentricity when he takes a last stand against the police to help the other team members escape from the mint. Who would have thought that the cruel, sadistic, narcissistic thief would sacrifice himself for the others? We know that Berlin knew that he was going to die because of his condition. But what makes his character so fascinating is that he decided to go on his own terms with dignity than die of humiliation and weakness as the disease gets worse.
Te quiero mucho, hermanito. No lo olvides.
¡Ne, profesor, ne!
Me he pasado la vida siendo un poco hijo de puta, pero hoy creo que me apetece morir con dignidad.
His last stand was brave and predictably made him a fan favorite. And that is it for the video, guys. Did you end up loving or hating Berlin? Please let us know in the comment section below. Also, do you think that we as viewers have started vouching for eccentric, crazy characters more than conventional protagonists? Let us know. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed the video, please like, share and subscribe.